indeed for coming over for this interesting talk, Cool Japan, a curatorial practice after Fukushima. Tonight we are honored to have Ms. Mizuki Takahashi, who is a senior curator at Contemporary Art Center Art Tower Mito. She's currently based in London as a research fellow in Central St. Martin's, University of the Arts London. She has realized interdisciplinary exhibitions addressing various contemporary cultures from manga, architecture, performance, film, music, and visual arts. Her curated exhibitions in and outside of Japan so far include 8 Days, Voice in Japan, which is held at Art Tower Mito in 2009, and Hamburger Bahnhof, Berlin 2011. Quiet Attentions, a Departure from Women, Art Tower Mito 2011. And Darren Armand's Second Thoughts, Art Tower Mito 2013. Now, today she's going to talk about a curatorial practice, rather a difficult one, since the Great East Japan earthquake on 11th of March 2011. I think almost everybody in this room knows about that. We did have an exhibition right after this disaster and had an artist talk. Ko Kawakami was the name of the artist, and then his theme of that exhibition was ruins. We asked a rather well-known writer. Now, who was the name? Do you remember Keiko-san? I just forgot. Dylan, Keiko-chan over there? You chose him to be a... And then what was his name? The writer who whose research was also about ruins. But he asked the artists, obviously, about the Great East Japan earthquake, the influence of the artists, and Kawakami-san couldn't answer straight away. He just went completely silent. But then, obviously, in his talk, it's all about the ruins, and as you can remember, the Fukushima power plant looked exactly like a ruin. And one of the audience asked Kawakami-san about that, and again, he couldn't answer. I think it was less than 2 months after the earthquake and Fukushima incidents. Anybody, not just Japanese, but especially artists who's got really sort of sensitive minds, I think at that time having difficulty how to face the impact. But then this author, a British person, he said something like, the influence will show at the oddest moment in the oddest form, or something like that. So I was kind of hoping to hear from Takahashi-san, it's not just the artists, but also the curators. They must have felt so much, and they must have faced so much difficulty in curating. The talk will be very, very interesting. I was personally very much looking forward to this talk today. So, Mizuki-san, I will hand it over to you. Thank you very much.
Brian Dillon, wasn't
yes.
it?
Yes,
Brian Dillon. Mm-hmm. Yes.
No, okay.
Good evening, everyone. Can you hear me? I think. Thank you very much, Ogawa-san and Japanese Foundation to give me an opportunity to talk about my experience after Fukushima disaster. Usually, I made a script when I giving the lecture, but this time
it was pretty difficult to still to reflect and write down what I experienced. So tonight is really live performance for me. So if I say something, I might something weird, but just let me excuse at the beginning. So today I'm going to talk about randomly what I experienced at the time of the triple disasters in March 11th in 2011. Then afterwards, I going to introduce my curatorial practice with the Japanese contemporary art, Tadashi Takamine. So let's start. So this is the Art Tower Mito, Contemporary Art Center Art Tower Mito, where I'm working for. Art Tower may sound little weird, but actually we have tower. It's 100 meters high because this cultural complex was built to commemorate 100 years anniversary of the Mito city government. So we have the music, theater, and contemporary art departments, and I'm the curator for the contemporary art department. And so this is a map of Japan. So
where is your
okay. So this is Tokyo, and Ibaraki is right there. So Mito is located in north part of, north of Ibaraki. So just between, sandwiched by Fukushima and Tokyo. So 100 kilometers away from the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. That's like that. So, and Art Tower Mito is, as I told you, a cultural complex. And when the earthquake hit in March 11th, in the contemporary art gallery, as Ogawa-san briefly mentioned, the contemporary women artist show, which I created, was going on. So this is an installation. Yeah, this is a view by the Japanese artist. This is before the earthquake, by the way. This is a large-scale installation by Fumiko Kobayashi and the other Japanese artist, Nobuko Tsuchiya. So, and I also invited some female artists from outside Japan. So this is the other installation by the Brazilian artist Laura Beren. So those artists made the site-specific work special for Art Tower Mito. So in March 11th, I was not in Mito at that time. I was in Tokyo to listen to the symposiums about women and art organized by the French embassy in Tokyo. So I was waiting for the opening of the symposium in the Asahi Hall at the top floor of the Marion in Yurakusho. It's very close to the Ginza. So when the earthquake hit, I thought, well, okay, this is a like normal earthquake. It's gonna be finished after 5 seconds or something, but it didn't. So it started shaking really strongly, and the people started screaming, and the spotlight above myself started to swing. So I really wanted to escape, but there was a lady sitting next to me. She was just frozen, so I couldn't, I couldn't remove her away, and then I was also stuck. So, but after the earthquake stopped, there was an announcement, oh, you have to get out from the building. So I had to get out from the building. So this is the pictures the immediately after the earthquakes. So I just thought, okay, maybe I'd better to go to the park next to the Imperial Palace, because I thought it's the most safe earthquakes in Tokyo. So, but as you can see, the people went out from the building and some wonders what was happening. So the guy was already wearing the helmet. So it was really cold, crowded day, and I didn't know what to do, but I thought what was happening in Mito, because I could know the earthquake hit north part of Japan, and even before the March 11th, I experienced that some relatively stronger earthquake hit Mito, city of Mito. So I tried to call to my colleague in Art Tower Mito, but I couldn't get through, so I sent some text to ask what's happening in Art Tower Mito, and my colleague replied, now there, the staff, there are all staff went out from the buildings, and now we are waiting in the courtyard, so blah, blah, blah. I realized I couldn't go back to Mito that day because I hardly ordered the public transportation stopped. Luckily, one of my friends is working for International Journalist Association. That office is just next to the building where the symposium was held. So my friend invited me to come over to that office, and because they had the food and drinks, and I decided to stay there. And next day, I went back to my parents' home. My parents are living in Tokyo, so. And I still kept contacting to my colleague, how's going, and they said, well, the exhibition is okay, but actually, the visitors of Art Tower Mito, they also couldn't go back to their home because all the public transportation stopped. So the visitors stayed in Art Tower Mito, and all my colleague worked to assist them to prepare the blanket and the food, everything. So, and meanwhile, I was watching the news, what was happening in Fukushima. So, and also then next to the Mito city, there is a town called Tokai Village, Tokai Mura, where the first nuclear reactor was built. So that also made me nervous. So what's gonna happen? Then, but I couldn't, I just wonder if I deal with, how to deal with this situation. And I also confirmed the artworks didn't get that heavy damage, so I sent an email to the artist to tell the condition of artworks and the situation in Mito. And all of the artists replied me, oh, you shouldn't think about the artworks at this urgent situation. You should think about, you should take off yourself and your family. So, then the 14th of March, before 15th, my boss, they sent me the email. So Mizuki-san, so now there is a bus started to running between the Tokyo and Tsukuba. Tsukuba is the university town. It's just middle of the Ibaraki prefecture. There is no train between Tsukuba and the Mito, but there is a bus. So my boss said, please come back to Mito using the bus. So I thought, okay, I have to go back to Mito to check what is happening, what was happening there. But on the other hand, to be honest, I really hesitate to go back to Mito, because Mito is relatively closer to Fukushima. and the explosions is happening, so all the radioactivity, you know, leaking from the exploded building, and my parents stopped me not to go back. But but I decided to go back to see what was happening. So on the 15th of March, I went to the shopping before going to back to Mito. I bought some food because I knew the stores closing down and the people is actually Mito is a motorized city, so if you don't have the car, it's really difficult for the shopping and to go to anywhere. So I and some of my colleagues, they don't have any car, and also I heard the they don't have enough petrol, so there is a long queue in front of petrol station to get the small amount of petrol for the cars. So I bought some kind of the food and snacks to deliver to my office. So when this is my neighborhood. It's just the 100 meters away from my apartment. So yeah, as you can see, the Mito city was like that. So this is very close to the Art Tower Mito, and this is the entrance hall of the Art Tower Mito. Interestingly, you know, this installation was standing. It's really strange, you know. So those kind of illogical and irrational things, which that's what I experience a lot. So I was really surprised. Wow, there's no damage on this, you know, looks fragile looking artworks. So I had a hope maybe I could continue the exhibition, but the pipe from the pipe organs, there is a pipe organ. There is a pipe organ in the, and we had the regular pipe organ concerts on the weekend. So the pipes falling down like that. So like that. This is really weird, isn't it? So you see all the noise is still sounding. The ceiling of the gallery fell down as well, and that destroyed the installation. Like this. So then I realized that I need to close the exhibition. So, But strangely, still, even though we had the damage of the building like that, but we are really lucky. We didn't get any serious damage on the artworks which we loaned. So I really wanted to deinstall all the artworks because some of the works I need to return to the owner, but we couldn't do that because we couldn't ask the technicians or installers to come to help us. So I was really nervous because still we had a lot of the strong aftershocks many times in a day. So that may cause the damage of the artworks, but we couldn't handle anything. So then the Art Tower Mito decided to close for a while to repair the damage of building, and the top of the Art Tower Mito announced that all the staff back to the home to take care of themselves and the family. So I planned many events related to the exhibitions, like symposium, workshops during the April, but I had to cancel everything. And also we couldn't see when Art Tower Mito would be reopened. So suddenly I lost everything to do in the office. So I decided to do something volunteer work instead of working for the office. So April, I went to this Sendai, is the north the Tohoku area, because my friend artist, her name's Rieko Shiga. She was living nearby the sea, and she lost everything, her studio and her works, and her data because of the tsunami. So, but she stayed, still she stayed in that area to and she worked to rescue the front of damaged the family album and the photo. So this is the area where she was working for. When I visited her, she took me to the evacuations house and house for the refugees, and she took me around the area. But at the beginning, I really hesitated to take the picture of this landscape. I felt guilty, and so, but after the after stayed the couple of hours, I decided to okay, I thought I should take the at least couple of photos. So yeah, this is the report which I saw. And this is a kind of a building, a community building, where all flooded the family album were collected. So they are waiting for the owners to come to pick up. So my friend artist late Diego was washing to prevent the more damage from those family photos, and I went to assist her. So, and meanwhile, there was the protest march was happening in the middle of Shibuya. So, as you can see, there are more police down there participants. So, and I also participated a couple of times, and I also went to Fukushima. This is the city method. It's usually used for the fairs or festivals or concert. So this building is used to the. the people who escaped from the area nearby Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. So some space was allocated for the authorized community, but the people who were not who didn't receive any instruction where to escape, so they just escaped this building, and they just occupied some area, so built those kind of partition to get their personal space. So, and I worked to kind of deliver the food and clothing to the refugees. So, and the build inside the buildings is totally chaotic, and there were some kind of sexual abuse was also happening there, but the local volunteers they introduced what was happening inside of this building, and suddenly I encountered the area which was designed by the Japanese architect, Shigeruban. Shigeruban is known as an architect to make the building for the emergency situation. So this time he also sent the parts of the partitions. I was really surprised because only this area was totally different from the other area, because people are living in order. So feel the kind of made me feel the security. And also this color of the texture used for this partition to work to recover certain kind of humanity or logical thinking. So I strongly felt the power of design at that time. So I spent the couple of months like this, and meanwhile, the Ministry of the Economy, Trade and Industry announced Cool Japan Industries Policy in May 2011. So they said they promote overseas advancement of an internationally appreciated Cool Japan brand. Well, obviously it was taken from the Cool Britannia policy, and cultivation of creative industries, promotion of these industries in Japan and abroad, and the other related initiative from cross-industry and cross-government standpoint. The policies and the initiative promoted here are based on proposal by Cool Japan Advisory Council in May 2011. Because I made the exhibitions about manga before, so I sometimes receive the invitation to talk about the mangas and also relationships manga and art in Japan. So, but this policy gave me a big question mark, because what they say under the Cool Japan industry policy is like that, you know, the kari, pam pam, or also the animation character wearing the Japanese yukata, and in front of Fuji Mountains, and also the Japanese food. Although the people worry about the food pollution by the radioactivity, so this policy made me confused. So why, you know, only 2 months passes, and why you can't say that? You know, still people are still struggling to how to handle. So it's not cooled down at all in Fukushima. So, and also after May, Art Tower Mito decided to open the institutions after the summer, so that we are requested to submit the exhibition program in next year. So those kind of things made me think, okay, what shall I do as a curator? What shall I do? What kind of exhibition I should make? Then I asked to the Tadasu Takamine, is a Japanese artist, to work together. So this is Tadasu. He is the contemporary artist and the theater director. So he is known as an artist to make the provocative art exhibition and performance addressing the kind of the subject regarded as a taboo in the Japanese society, like sexuality of handicaps, and also the diplomatic relationship between the Japan and America, and also the Korean-Japanese program. So, but so he is the, also the he was also member of internationally acclaimed performance group Dumptype. Dumptype was the active performance artist collective in 1980s to early 1990s. So they are the first artist collective to the addressing the problem of the sexuality, because the leading member of Dumptype, Teiji Furuhashi, actually, in fact, he suffered HIV, and he through the their performance, Dumptype provoked the argument about the sexuality and also prejudice or about the gay people. So, and also the Tadasu as an individual, he has made an exhibition to questions about the living infrastructure. And when he's now father of four children. So when he had to think about where to live, so he just then he checked if he should buy the house or he should rent the house, and he realized housing industry is so crazy. So as maybe the people in this country also facing the to get the affordable house, you know. So he, although there's many abolished house, actually it's empty house and tenants in the middle of the city. So he used the he built this temporary house in the gallery, used the parts of demolished house. And also this is the other artworks entitled Super Capacitor. Super Capacitor is the name of the storage battery invented by the Japanese company. So the one of the the super capacitor has the characteristics. They have the power to accumulate the electric energy immediately, then also release very quickly. So once you employ the super capacitors, we can save the production of the the electric energy. So, but that's caused the problem for the energy industry. So that's why there's many barriers in the market. So there's many obstacles to promote the supercapacitors. So he decided to use his exhibition as an apparatus to public to the public relations or promote supercapacitors. You know, so we have supercapacitors. If we can use these technologies, we can save the energy. You know, so this is the other installation view. So he already had concerned about the problem about energy or living infrastructure. That's why I decided to work with him, and would like to discuss with him how to confront with the problem, the disaster which we experienced. So, this is also to work with him and also to make the exhibition in for Art Tower Mito. We had to be sensitive because, as I told you, there is a Fukushima Tokai village just located next to the city of Mito. Also, the Fukushima is relatively closer to Mito, and so many people in our neighborhood actually engaged in the nuclear power industry. One of our volunteers worked for, as a laborer for the nuclear power plant, and also the one of the volunteers, see her family was running the noodle shop for the laborers in Fukushima nuclear power plant, Daiichi nuclear power plant. So that all those see her family lost everything for the disaster. So, and also the husband of ex volunteers woman, he was the top engineer of the Hitachi new engineer company, and even after the accident, he worked for the building the new nuclear reactor in China, and he repeatedly said, "You don't have to worry about that much about the radioactivity from Fukushima." So the situation is quite complicated. It's complicated, and while we are talking about what to do, what we should, what to produce as exhibitions, this the official report of Fukushima Nuclear Accident Independent Investigation Commission was released in 2012. So the message from chairman, actually the chairman, Mr. Dr. Kiyoshi Kurokawa, he's a medical doctor, and coincidentally, he is the husband of my mother's best friend. So they released the report in Japanese, both in Japanese and English. And the English report, he said, what must be admitted very painfully is that this was a disaster made in Japan. Its fundamental causes are to be found in ingrained conventions of Japanese culture, our reflective obedience, our reluctance to question authority, our devotion to sticking with the program, our groupism, and our insularity. However, this sentence was not written in the report, written in Japanese. So the Japanese of the journalist of the Mainichi newspaper questioned to the Mr. Kurokawa, why you didn't write this sentence in the Japanese report? And he replied, he answered, so he answered, but actually he questioned to the journalist, do you think, he replied that this report is for the international society, so do you think Japanese can understand Japanese kind of Japanese conventions? Is, you know, even, yeah, he asked if Japanese can understand this cause, this comes from the Japanese culture. So this fired us. So then we decided to make the Tadas Takamine's Cool Japan. So, okay, so let's think about, so what is the Japanese culture through our exhibition. So it's quite a long sentence, but this is a statement by Tadas Takamine. So as you can see in the red, what we made up of and how ourselves and identity created. So this is a kind of the counter questions to the report and the Cool Japan kind of policy. So there's each gallery. So this exhibitions divided in the seven rooms, and every room has a different theme. So in each year, Takamine presents a different aspect of the essence of Japanese culture, as well as a number of sculptures modeled after people chosen from suburban Mito, Tokyo, and other areas. These students, housewives, musicians, diet members, and others from all walks of life are representative of the people of Japan living in the post-Fukushima world. So we did a lot of interviews before making the exhibitions, not only the victims or anti-nuclear people, but also we also went to the interview who worked for the nuclear power industry. Also, we went to do the interview of the family of the engineer. So this is the entrance. So the exhibitions spontaneously become the theatrical set. So the audience had to request it to play or how to react what we showed in the gallery. So the audience is requested to how to behave to what they are looking at. So first room is the Cool Japan room. So, and we handed out the gallery guide to all the visitors. And we also gave the short description. It's quite ironical description about each room. So the Cool Japan rooms after the end of war, Japan experienced the miraculous period of rapid economic growth, transforming itself into the consumer paradise where any material desire could be freely satisfied as long as one had the money to indulge in it, like that. So, and this is the Cool Japan room. And sorry, see, the image is not that clear, but this is a detail. So, as you can see, the creature-like people are rushing to the shopping. And this image was inspired by Japanese departmental store is the full of lighting system. And if you experienced in Japanese New Year's, you may know the Japanese department store sell the kind of lucky bag, it's so called fukubukuro. So you cannot know what is in the lucky bag, you know, but the lucky bag is sold like 25 pounds or, you know, the 50 pounds or something like that. So then once you get the fukubukuro without knowing what they are selling, so one, then you can, you know, you can open that bag once you go back to your house and figure out what is inside there. So most of the case, they just sell the, you know, the stock from the stock, and yeah, like this. And the next room is the lost room. To make the exhibition, we did a lot of the research about the fact from the newspaper. So we have now 54 nuclear reactors, but there was actually many lost cases, but most of the case citizens lost. So he selected the he picked up the headline of the newspaper showing the lost code. So and transformed to the three-dimensional like. The block pushing, you know, the audience. So there is the sculpture. So we made the six sculptures, the models from the citizens. So that the sculpture inspired from the citizens of Calais by Rodin, Auguste Rodin. So the all the poses are taken from the citizens of Calais. So. This. So yeah, for instance, this is the old newspaper of the Japan Times. Sorry, this is it's raw image, but we collected those the fact. And to move to the next gallery, you have to get through this nasty curtain made by the plastic. A black plastic paper. So this is a Hyogo room. So Hyogo, the Japanese slogans and the mottos that condense a profound thought on sentiment into the short sentence, 5, 7, and 5 syllables. So actually, it's many local government calling for this hyogo from the citizens. So if you go to the Japanese, well, even in the public transportations or this the corner of the street corner, you can find a lot of slogans. You have to behave like that, or you should be kind to the others like that. So then he made genie holes are like the right installation. So that he is kind of taking the shower of the slogan. So I have to be concerned about time. So the next room is Gaman room. So then after the earthquake, the Japanese said Japanese was really patient. The people were queuing up to get the food, not to break in the store. So, but there is the both side of coin in being patient. So sometimes being patient become the oppression to speak out what we are really thinking. So this is an installation view. Actually, there's many speakers, small speakers hanging from the ceiling, and many different voices saying, be patient. So the adult sculpture also taking the shower of the voice of being patient. So room of free expression is, for this installation, we picked up the people's voice from the online world, from Twitter or Facebook, you know, those kind of world. So then we made this kind of apocalyptic installation. And the next room is like highlight of this exhibition. It's the Japan Syndrome Room. So before the Mito exhibition, Tadasu has made the video works in Yamaguchi, it's the west part of Japan, and also Kyoto. So this red dot is the number of the nuclear reactor in Japan. So he asked the performer to carry the spy camera and let them to ask about the effect of the nuclear accident on the food in the shop or restaurant. Then they secretly record the conversation because people don't talk, you know, freely or openly if you are carrying the camera like that. So then we recorded the conversation with spy camera. Then the performers reenact the conversation, what they experienced. So this is an installation view, then I will show some of the video.
The full screen, I don't know.
じゃあ
こんにちは。
お、This is octopus、
うん、
and this is a squid、
うん、
What is this? This is a dried fish.
Funny.、
Huh?
I've never seen this.
Really?
No.、
Mm-hmm.
What is this?
This is a seaweed.
It's good、
mm-hmm.
and smells terrible.、
Mm-hmm.
What is this?
This fish,、
mm.
I have no idea. Shall we bring it?、
Hmm?
Yeah, we can ask the woman.
Which one?
Which one do you want? That one? That one? Okay.
Yeah. Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
どっちかったらおつまみコンビいかがですか?
Seaweed. A pickled seaweed. You want to try?
Yeah. おいしい?
おいしいと思います.
いい味ついてますから。
Yeah, you should just try. If you don't want, give it to me. Okay?
ダメだったら出してね。 もしよろしかったら。
残したら食べます。
おいしい?
おいしい?
Really? I'll keep it. Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Very good one.
はい。
どうぞ。硬いからね、噛んでないとね。とっても美味しい。よかったです。いい味ついてると思います。If
you don't like it, I can take yours as well.
No. I like it. Don't give it.
じゃあこちらお包みしましょうか?
May I ask first, where is the fish coming from?
すみません、これってどこさんですかね?
これは千葉ですね。
So what shall we do?
すみません、ちょっと彼女海外から来てて心配してるんですけど、この辺で取れたお魚とかってその大丈夫なんですかね。まあね、一応ね、検査は通ってますから大丈夫だと思うんだけど。 These fishes are already checked.
まあ不安になられますよね。
You must be worried.
海はね、繋がってるからね。
She understands how you feel because she's connected everywhere, you know?
そうですね。
Yeah, it's natural how you feel. やっぱりそうやって
心配であれば。
そうですね。
心配だったら外国産のお魚をお勧めしてますね。
そうなんです。 Yeah, she recommends you to have one that's from the other countries.
心配であればね。
If you worry, やっぱそうやって聞かれるお客さんって。そうですね。 I just ask her, are there some customer for us like you?
Foreigner.
Yeah, foreigner, I mean. じゃあその心配だったら買わない方がいいっていう感じ。もうね、それはね、その方の考え方次第ですからね。 Yeah, it depends on you. If you worry, you'd better not to buy, she says.
でも心配しながら食べても美味しいから。心配しながら食べても美味しいからって。
She says, if you worry, the taste may not be good for you.
What about you? Do you worry about any fish or food?
この辺のお魚とかってやっぱ心配されてますか?
私は大丈夫だと思ってます。
She thinks it must be okay.
一応検査通ってますし。
Because these fishes are already checked.
もうね、それはね、信じるしかないですよね。 もうお野菜でも何でもね。
そうですよね。 Yeah, all they can do is to trust the check result. Also for the vegetables, you know.
But where do they usually check the fishes? In the companies or later when they come to the shops? Where do they do that?
すみません、こういうものってどこで検査とかはされてるんですか? ここのお店とかでも?
いや、ここではやってないです。
Not in the shop.
ダメだったらね、入ってこないですから。 安全で大丈夫なやつだけ買い出して出してるので。
Yeah, they only buy the fishes after examined, so which means they are all safe.
I see. So they check the fish somewhere and then they send it to the shop.
That's right. Yeah. Otherwise, they will stop it at the market.
そうね。シシャモ。はいはい。シシャモ。 国産なノルウェー産なんですけれども。
This is from Norway.
From Norway. 国産のはね、ちょっとね、高いからね。そうなんですね。シシャモは柔らかい、イワシに比べて焼いても硬くならないし。心配だったらシシャモをおすすめします。そうですか。
Yeah, she recommends it. It should be good.
骨もないし、食べやすいです。そうですか。
What do you think? It looks really oishi.
Yeah, oishi.
Yeah, let's buy this one.
This one? Okay. あ、すみません。じゃあ、はい、これ一ついただいてもいいですか。
はい、ありがとうございます。はい、はい、じゃあこちら640円になります、
はい、じゃあ1000円から
。はい、1000円お預かりします。はい、お返しです。
はい、はい、You take it?
Yeah. うん、はい、どうぞ。
ありがとうございます。
どうもありがとうございました。
ありがとうございました。
すいません、すいません。
はい、
これください。
はい。
あ、ちなみにこのお弁当ってどこさんのものが使われてるかとか分かりますか。
どこさん、
茨城のもの使ってるんですかね。
ん、
茨城のもの使ってるんですかね。
いや、茨城のものとは限らないですね。
そうですか。
ご飯はそうですけど。何か。
あ、いや、あんまり気にしないようにはしてるんですけど。
はい。
あの、まあ実家が関西で。
はい。
まあ割とその放射能のこととか結構心配されたので、もし何かそういうのがあれば。
向こうの東北の方のは扱ってないですね。
ああ、そうですか。茨城のお米とかもまあ。
どうしたの？うん、産地が。うん？何？
どこ産のものなのかなとか。
ああ、茨城です。放射の。
ああ、大丈夫大丈夫。
ああ、そうですか。
うん、大丈夫です。そういう心配はありません。
検査とかしてるんですかね、県とか国とか。
うん、茨城は大丈夫でしょ。
あ、うん、大丈夫ですか。
あっちの方じゃないしね。
ああ。
はい、大丈夫ですよ。はい。
じゃあこれください。
はい、300円です。
Well, I would like to, I didn't want to show the, all of the episode, but if I show this one, it's take, I need more than 40 minutes, so I, unfortunately, I have to close, then I have to restart. This was the performance which we made in Mito, but he also made the Kyoto and the Yamaguchi. That also showed how different area, the people in the different area react the incident or accident differently. So, And after, well, the Japan's, until the Japan syndrome, we focused on mainly domestic matter. But next room, we showed, we called it nuclear family room. In this room, also we surveyed the number of nuclear tests all around the world. So then we counted there are 1,056 nuclear tests was conducted by the U.S. and 715 by former Soviet Union and also the other countries. So we put the all the record of nuclear power tests on the wall, and above the list, the Takamine exhibited that his family photo chronologically from 1945 to 2007. So
why we stopped the 2007, but because we couldn't find the more reliable record after 2007. So this is a photo of Takamine's father, maybe around 1945, and Takamine's mother photo, and his family photo to show how these peace of the family are supported by the so-called peaceful use of nuclear power. So, and the last room, we didn't put any description though, but it's called the transitions room. This is like really like the theater set. It's a shame I couldn't show the video, but once you get inside the dark room, there is the beach-like set, and the searchlight is moving on the surface of the sand. And also in the room, the song by children, the played. And the searchlight is showing the crossing. Actually, this is a crossing of the model of the sculpture. So, but it's also the remind of the remind the people of the after victim of tsunami. And with the song, there is a loud voice saying "Oi, oi!" The audience can hear. So it's some people think that is the voice of the searching for the victims, or some people think this is a voice from death. And also the monitor that shows the Takamine's performance. He is beating or cultivating the ground with the pipe, the iron pipe. So that is the older installation. And also in accordance of the exhibition, we also organized the discussion. The artist talk, which we organized the closing day. So the many audience come to see what Takamine says. But actually, this audience is not for the art gallery goal. Also, we had the anti-nuclear power activists, also the journalists, also the victims. So this artist talk become the big kind of symposium or forum that everybody's, you know, people's different the background, the speech, you know, speech out what they are thinking. So some anti-nuclear activists strongly, aggressively criticized Japanese journalists, and he said, you must know what was happening. You must know the Fukushima nuclear power reactor was melted down at that time, although you didn't, your mass media didn't broadcast, but the gains that criticized the journalist said, well, as an individual artist, I didn't know that kind of argument is happening. And also, even after closing the show, the artists organized the discussion about this show. So I didn't have any, can I say, I'm still thinking or reflecting what we did by this exhibition, but this is the Cool Japan proposal issued in 2014. And by the Cool Japan Movement Promotion Council in the Japanese cabinet. And they said, inside the proposal, they said, Japan, the country that provides a creative solution to the world's challenges. Maybe our exhibition might provide one of these. So thank you.